Since I was a child, the Castle Market has had a permanent mark of sadness etched in my mind. There were many winter evenings in the 1980s going through this area, travelling on the 52 bus to the City Library. I found Castle Market and Waingate very depressive and run down. The last time I went inside Castle Market was over 35 years ago, and I have never been inclined to go there since. Recently, this area is in the process of redevelopment, and I was intrigued to see if the atmosphere, as well as the physical space, has changed in any way. I decided to catch the 52 bus, the same bus route I took as a child. As I travelled through the wicker, getting closer to the Castle Market, a sense of foreboding came over me. As the bus approached Waingate, for the first time in my life, I made a conscious effort to get off the bus here and walk down to a new place called Love Square. It is here I started my journey and wandered around the perimeter of Castlegate. I will do a video on Love Square another time. Let us head towards Snigg Hill. There are three points of interest here. We are now on Snigg Hill. Snigg Hill might get its name from the wedges that were put behind the horse cart's wheels when they stopped on hills to stop them rolling backwards. The wedges were called snigs. It is very quiet, 7:30 a.m. This was called the Black Swan or the Mucky Duck. This pub in the 1970s hosted numerous famous bands, including Joe Cocker, AC/DC, The Clash, Status Quo and the Sex Pistols. Recent performances included Pulp and Arctic Monkeys. A striking brick mosaic on the side of a building on Castle Street by Paul Waplington. It was commissioned by the council in the 1980s to commemorate the steel industry of Sheffield. It is based on a real steel worker. Our third point of interest is the famous Vulcan, God of Fire, by Boris Tites. It was commissioned in 1961 by Horn Brothers Limited, a men's outfitters company. The sculpture is made of glass fibre on a metal armature, holding a bundle of metal rods. Vulcan also appears on the Sheffield coat of arms. We are now heading down High Street. In the distance, this used to be the old Central Post Office, built in 1910. Since 1999, it has remained empty. Recently, it is the home of the Arts and Design Department. We are now at the top end of Castlegate. This road is called Haymarket. We will go down here, but let's continue around the perimeter of Castlegate area first. We are now on Commercial Street. In the distance, you can see the famous Park Hill flats. I will do a separate video dedicated to this in the future. I am a little uncertain where to go. Let's wander down here. The square, apartments and empty office blocks. In front is Park Square Roundabout, one of the main exit points out of the city. We are now on River Sheaf Walk. Believe it or not, we are following the River Sheaf, which is underneath this path. This area and surrounding areas were notorious for flooding. The two major floods were 1864 and recently in 2007. This is part of Sheffield's grey to green scheme. We are heading towards Castlegate, which is now pedestrianised. Just crossed Exchange Street. We will go up there to look at the castle area, but first we will continue on Castlegate. This is Exchange Place Studios, a stunning Art Deco building, recently refurbished, offering artists with studio space. Alexandra House is student flats now, but it used to be called Alexandra Theatre. Around 1850s, it was a combination of a circus and theatre named Adelphi for inmates of the Sheffield workhouse. This is an old photo of the backstage of Alexandra Theatre. You can clearly see how the building was held up above the River Sheaf. In 1881, this section of the River Sheaf was culverted underground. I cannot believe the difference. This is the start of Castlegate. In the past, I have driven down here. Looking at this 1926 map, the red cross on the map is where we are now. This is where Castle Folds Lane used to be, circa 1800, heading south towards Exchange Street. Around 1819, Shambles Lane was created, which linked the slaughterhouses to Castle Folds Lane. Looking down here to the left, I believe this is where the slaughterhouses were. Around here, they are going to open up a small part of the River Sheaf and create a new embankment. It will be interesting what they do here. I believe students from Hallam University created this street art, depicting the Sheffield history and the castle. River Don and the famous Ladies Bridge. Ladies Bridge is the oldest bridge across the River Don. The original bridge was made out of wood in circa 1150. In 1485, the Vicar of Sheffield, Sir John Pleasance, and William Hill, Master Mason, agreed to build the bridge out of stone at a cost of £67. A small chapel dedicated to the Virgin Mary was built close to the bridge, hence the bridge became known as Our Lady's Bridge. The chapel was converted for use as a wool warehouse in 1547 to prevent its demolition as part of the dissolution of the monasteries during the reign of Henry VIII, and was subsequently used as an almshouse or poor hospital house. We are now going up Waingate. To the right is Bridge Street. This is where we started at Love Square. This is the Sheffield Magistrates Court, designed in 1978 by B. Warren, in the brutalist style of concrete. For me, in the 1980s, this area was a no-go area at night. Walking up here in daylight, I still sense the ambience of that time. I feel uneasy. This is the old town hall, courthouse and prison, built in 1808 in neoclassical style. This is where most of the time power resided. It is where judges and magistrates sat in court, where the police were based, and where modern politics and local government in Sheffield began. It has been empty for over 25 years. This is going to be redeveloped into apartments, yet another hotel in the cells, together with an underground retail and workshop area, intriguingly called the Souk. We are now going to turn left and go down Exchange Street. We are now on Exchange Street. To the right was part of the Castle Market called the Gallery. There used to be a bridge connecting this to the main market building. Not too sure what they are going to do with these old buildings. I hope they will not pull these down. Believe it or not, under my feet is the River Sheaf and the Megatron. The City Council is hoping to open up the last few hundred yards of the River Sheaf from the Megatron to the River Don in a park to be called Sheaf Field. Let's have a quick look at the castle site. Not much to be seen here, but I've put links to other YouTube videos that better show what is going on. To finish this video, I will quickly show and tell you three quick facts about three streets coming off Waingate: King Street, Castle Street and Bridge Street. We are now at the top end of Waingate. Let's walk down. The first road to the left is called King Street. This used to be called Pudding Lane. The next street down is called Castle Street. This used to be called Truelove's Gutter. A family called the Truelove's lived in this street. The gutter probably reflects that most streets in Old Sheffield doubled up as drains, which were flushed periodically by opening Barker's Pool Reservoir, removing debris, dead cats and worse to the River Don at Ladysbridge. Finally, here we are at Bridge Street near Love Square. This street used to be called Under the Water. Because this street was at a lower level with steps going up to Ladysbridge, it was frequently flooded by the River Don, hence the name Under the Water. The ambience has certainly changed, but I still sense a lingering of the old and see remnant scars of deprivation. I feel, depending on funding, it will still take several more years before I completely shred my sad memories of the 1980s and 90s. Castlegate is still in a slow transition period, and I have mixed emotions now. I am very impressed with the redevelopment of making Castlegate a pedestrianised area. The greater green screen is still very encouraging. Since leaving the European Union, there will be limited funding, and it is very hard to see where it would come from to finish the redevelopment. Going forward, the council should be imaginative, creative, bold, and respect the whole history of this area. Because some Sheffield people loved the Castle Market, I think they should include three main goals. 1. they should retain some characteristic feature of the castle market. Two, they should identify the importance of the original historic past of the castle and how it served Sheffield previous to the Industrial Revolution. Lastly, the third and most crucial goal is to attract tourism. They should focus this area on a thriving creative hub of art, music, food and culture. My big concern is, let's hope they will not use this land for short-term profit, student flats and office blocks.